Hello and welcome to 3D Nato. My name is Renato, and in today's video I'll show you how to model this object in Blender following a technical draw. Let's take a look at the technical draw and decide where to start sketching the object. For this object here, I think I'll start on this top view. The next thing I like to do is to break the object into basic shapes. Here you can see that we have three basic shapes. The first one is this 20mm radius semicircle. The second one are these two 10mm radius semicircles that are 40mm apart. And the third one is this 130x40mm rectangle. These two smaller 50x10mm rectangles here, I'll leave it for the front view sketch. I'm going to start my sketch with this 20mm radius semicircle. With that in mind, let's start sketching. The first thing I like to do is to delete everything in a scene and set units length to millimeters. Press A to select all objects in the scene and X to delete. And on scene, go to units and set length to millimeters. To go to top view in Blender, just press numpad 7. To create a circle, press Shift plus A, go to mesh and select circle. Expand the add circle menu, leave vertices at 32 and set radius to 20mm. To zoom on a circle, press numpad dot. Press Shift plus A, go to mesh, and select circle. Leave vertices at 32 and set radius to 10mm. To create the second one, let's duplicate this circle. For this, I'll use some Blender shortcuts to duplicate and move it 40mm to the right at the same time. Press Shift plus D to duplicate the circle so we have two 10mm radius circles. Press X to lock the object on X axis so it only moves left and right, type 40 to move it 40mm to the right, and enter to confirm. Now let's join these circles together. Select all circles, making sure to select the bigger one last to keep its origin point, and press Ctrl plus J. Now these three circles are part of the same mesh. Let's rename this mesh. With the object selected, press F2 and rename it. I'll call it TechDraw 01. Press Tab to go to Edit Mode. To achieve the shape we need for this object, I'm going to delete half of these circles. A simple way to do this is to select these three vertices, press Ctrl plus plus sign 7 times to select more, X to delete, and select vertices. That will leave us with three semicircles. Let's connect the two smaller ones to create the whole shape. To connect vertices with an edge, select two vertices and press F to create a new edge. Now I'm going to extrude these two vertices of the bigger circle to the center of the smaller one to the right. Just remember that the distance between these two smaller circles is 40mm. To do that, select these two vertices, press E to extrude, X to lock axis, type 40, and enter to confirm. With the basic shape almost complete, let's start adding some faces to this mesh. I'm going to start with this bottom four vertices here, and you'll see why. Select these four vertices and press F to create a new face. Now, all we have to do to create the other faces is to select this edge here and press F until all faces are created. To finish this part, all we have to do now is to extrude this edge loop two more times. But let's take another look at the drawing to check the distances. Here you can see that the first one will be 40mm and the second one will be 50mm. With that in mind, let's finish this part on mesh. Select this edge loop, press E to extrude, X to lock axis, type any positive number, and enter to confirm. This extrude value is not important now. We'll fix that later. First, we need to make this edge loop flat on X axis. To do this, press S to scale, X to lock axis, type 0, and enter to confirm. To set this edge loop location, press N to show the sidebar, set transform to global, and X to 80mm, which is 40mm apart from the second 10mm circle. Now let's extrude one last time. Press E to extrude, X to lock axis, type 50, and enter to confirm. This will create and move the last edge loop to 130mm on the X axis, which is the end position of the bottom mesh. A way to check if every distance is correct is to enable edge length in mesh edit mode overlays. Go to Mesh Edit Mode Overlays, Measurement, and check Edge Length. Now just select these four edges here and check the distances. These three faces length should be 40mm on the first one, 40mm on the second one, 50mm on the third one, and 10mm wide. Now let's start sketching the front view. Here, the main basic shape is this 50mm diameter semicircle with this 30mm diameter hole. Just keep in mind they are specified in diameter instead of radius. Let's check our measures to place this 50mm semicircle. As this line here is the origin point of the bottom mesh, we calculate the position based on this point. On x-axis, we need to place it at 130mm minus the radius, which is 25mm. Just remember that the radius is the diameter divided by 2. On y-axis, as we can see on the top sketch, we need to place it at 40mm divided by 2, which is 20mm. On z-axis, we need to place it at 40mm. And the circle will need to be rotated 90 degrees on x-axis. Let's do this now. While still in edit mode, press Shift plus A and select circle. Leave vertices at 32, set radius to 25mm, x location to 105mm, y location to minus 20mm, z location to 40mm, and x rotation to 90 degrees. Press numpad 1 to go to front view and numpad dot to zoom on selection. Press Shift plus A and select circle. Leave vertices at 32, set radius to 15mm, x location to 105mm, y location to minus 20mm, z location to 40mm, and x rotation to 90 degrees. Let's delete half of the bigger circle. Select this bottom vertex, press Ctrl plus plus sign 7 times to select more, X to delete, and select vertices. To create the faces, select these 4 vertices, press F to create a new face, select this edge, and press F until all faces are created. Select this edge loop, press E to extrude, Z to lock axes, type any negative number, and enter to confirm. This value is not important now, we'll fix that later. First, we need to make this edge loop flat on Z-axis. To do this, press S to scale, Z to lock axes, type 0, and enter to confirm. Now we need to refine the bottom mesh and create loop cuts to join these two parts later on. But first we need to enable snap to vertex. Click this magnet icon to enable snap, instead snap base to vertex. Click and hold the middle mouse to rotate the view until you can see both meshes. Now press Ctrl plus R to create a loop cut on the bottom mesh, left mouse to create, hover the mouse cursor over a vertex on the top mesh, and left mouse again to confirm. Repeat these steps until you have created a loop cut for every vertex position. Now we need to add thickness to these meshes. Let's look at the drawing again. Here on the side sketch, we can see that both have 10mm. To create the thickness, we'll extrude these meshes. Let's start with the bottom mesh. With the mouse cursor over the mesh, press L to select it, E to extrude, type 10, and enter to confirm. Select the front mesh, press E to extrude, type 10, and enter to confirm. Now we need to join these parts together. But first we need to delete some faces. Press V to face selection, select the first face, hold Ctrl, select the last face, press X to delete, and select faces. Repeat the same steps on the other mesh. Press 2 to edge selection, hold Alt, and click on any edge of that loop to select it. Now hold Shift plus Alt, and click on the second edge to select both edge loops. To join these edge loops, we're going to use Bridge Edge Loops. To create it, press Ctrl plus E, and select Bridge Edge Loops. And to refine the mesh, select this middle edge loop, press X to delete, and select Dissolve Edges. And to make sure the normals are correct, press A to select all, and Shift plus N to recalculate normals. The modeling part is now complete. As this is a symmetric object, instead of modeling both sides, all we have to do now is to use a mirror modifier to finish this project. Go to Top View, disable Snap, uncheck Edge Length Overlay, press 1 to Vertex Selection, and Alt plus Z to enable X-ray mode. When enabled, selection isn't occluded by the object's geometry, allowing to select everything inside the selection box. Select all vertices above the Y-axis center, press X to delete, and select faces. press Tab to exit edit mode, and Alt plus E to disable X-ray mode. Go to Modifiers, click Add Modifier, go to Generate, add a mirror modifier, and set mirror axis to Y axis. To apply the modifier, click this arrow and select Apply, or just hover the mouse cursor over the modifier and press Ctrl plus A. And for last, right mouse click and select Shade Auto Smooth. The object is now complete. If you want to go further and add a subdivision surface modifier, just make sure to crease all sharp corners. If you're still here, it means you are liking the content of this channel. I really want to thank you for spending your time with me learning some basic Blender. I hope you have enjoyed as much as I have making it. So please, consider subscribing to the channel, like the video, share it, and leave a comment. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you on the next one. Bye bye.